Debt is a very serious matter and it should be dealt with in a very serious manner. Loan, when taken on the part of the debtor, it is an amana and it is a promise. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Mu'minun, narrating the behavior of the believers, says, وَالَّذِينَ لِأَمَانَاتِهِمْ وَأَحْدِهِمْ رَعُونَ, that the believers and mu'minun are the people who protect and who look after and who take care of their amana and their promises. So it is a very grievous and unforgivable sin to die without paying off one's debts. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam hadith narrates, Hazrat Abu Musa Ashari radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Musnad Ahmad and Abu Dawood that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that after the major sins, that is finding partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in adultery, that after the major sins from which Allah has strictly enjoined us to abstain, the greatest sin is that a man dies in a state that he owed a debt to anyone and left behind no assets to pay it off. Similarly, in another hadith reported by Sayyidina Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Muslim, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that if a person is killed in the path of Allah, all his sins are forgiven except for loan. So this is the importance of trying to pay off the loan. Similarly, Hazrat Abu Qatada radiallahu ta'ala anhu reports in Muslim that a person came and he asked that, O Messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, tell me that if I take part in jihad with fortitude and steadfastness and solely for the sake of earning the good pleasure of Allah and the reward of hereafter, and I get killed in the condition that I am not retreating but advancing, will all my sins be recovered? Will all my sins be forgiven? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, yes, all your sins will be forgiven except a debt. This is what I have been told by Jibreel alayhi salam. So this is the importance of trying to pay off the debt and loan before death. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's manner and routine we learn by a hadith. Hazrat Salma bin Aqwa radiallahu ta'ala and who reports in Bukhari that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was requested to lead the Salah funeral. And when he used to arrive to lead the funeral of Salah, the first thing he used to ask about the deceased was that, was any debt payable for the deceased? And when somebody used to say and used to ask and tell that he had to pay some amount of debt, then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to ask the heirs to pay the debt off from the property of inheritance. And if there was no inheritance left, then he used to request and ask the heirs to pay off the debt. And if the heirs did not want to or could not pay off the debt, then he used to request the relations of the kin or the Muslim brothers or the friends or the relatives to pay off the debt. And if none of them could or did not pay the debt, then Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith tells us, when the debt was not paid, he never used to lead the funeral prayer himself. He used to ask somebody else to lead this funeral prayer, and he used to leave himself. This was just to convey the dislike of not paying the debts. So this is why we need to be extremely sensitive about paying the debts. Similarly, there's a hadith reported by Hazrat Abu Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu in Bukhari that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, whoever borrows money from anyone and has the intention to return it, Allah will make it possible for him to pay it back. That is, Allah will help him clear it up because he had intention of doing so. And if he cannot do so in his lifetime, Allah will settle it on his behalf in hereafter and thus release him of the responsibility. And then the hadith says, and whoever borrows from anyone and has no intention of paying it back, Allah will have it destroyed, that the money will not only prove as a curse in afterlife, but in this world too, it will be of no help or comfort to him. So, if somebody has a debt, he should definitely make an intention and Allah will help him. Similarly, Hazrat Imran bin Hussein رضي الله تعالى عنه reports in Nisai that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, whoever takes a loan and it is in the knowledge of Allah that he has the intention of returning it, Allah will have it repaid in his lifetime. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has taught us a dua, Allahumma kfini an halalika an haramik wa aghnini bifadlika amman sivak. And hadith by Hazrat Abdullah bin Jafar reported in Ibn Majah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, God is with the debtor until the debt is paid, until the debt is paid, provided that it was not taken for a wrong purpose.